due to inbreeding, there is a differentiation of population into lines. So next is differentiation into lines, family or sub population. So if we go ahead all the base population, so ultimately due to the inbreeding increases or go ahead, it will produce different lines or families, different subpopulation, it will divide. That means within the same population, within the same lines, individuals have a less variation, but population to population or family to family or lines to line, there is a genetic difference are there. So this is one is there. Another point is, due to inbreeding, there is a homozygous animal, particularly for the dominant genes, are more prepotent. So homozygous, so prepotency. So homozygous genotype, particularly generally dominant genotypes, they are prepotent. Very important word is there. So what is prepotent? Prepotent means the ability of stamping the same characters to the next generation, that is called stamping nature. When same sets of genes in the parent comes into the next generation, so due to inbreeding, there is a prepotent, dominant genes are there, so increasing of the prepotency, prepotent animals. So that same character will come in the next generation also, in the offspring also. Another one is inbred uniformity within the lines, increase the uniformity within lines, okay. And there is a, if you see that this is the base population, and due to when the inbreeding ahead, so there is different lines will there. So within the same lines, there will be variation, variability of the animals will be less, but between the lines, there is more difference will be there. So this is called uniformity within the lines. So this is another one, points of effects of inbreeding. And another one is uncovering the recessive genes. Another one is uncovering the recessive genes. So due to inbreeding, there is a point number 7, uncovering the recessive genes. That means if we take the first example, that all the plants were 100% was heterozygous. That means this is already this. If it is a both the genes has a dominant recessive relationship, then this is recessive genes and this is dominant genes. So this was hidden by the dominant genes. So after some few generations of inbreeding, what happens? That will be an increasing of homozygous dominant genes, and also there is a increasing of homozygous recessive genotype. So ultimately with the expanses of heterozygous genotype, so whatever remaining as a hidden fact carrier, that will expose. Ultimately this portion is uncovering the recessive genes. So this is all about our different effects of genetic effects of inbreeding. So from the genetic effects of inbreeding, what we are seeing we are seeing that due to inbreeding, there is a increase of homozygosity and decrease of heterozygous individual, and also there is a genotype will gene frequency will not increase, it will be same. So now another one is your phenotyping effect of phenotypic effect of inbreeding. That means what is the overall appearance of the animals? What if you see the phenotypes? What we are seeing previously, what is happening in its genetic level? But in case of phenotypic, what is the different effects? The first is due to inbreeding, there is a recessive genotypes. So there is a more undesirable traits will come. So first is undesirable traits appear in increasing frequency. Undesirable traits comes into increasing frequency. So undesirable traits. Now question is how? Already I told you, all the animals which are, there is a heterozygous condition, this is, you know, all the recessive homozygous genotype are generally lethals or sublethals. So there are three types of genotypes. So this genotype, that is recessive genotypes, are undesirable or mainly produce the lethal effect, lethal or sublethal effect. So since it is increasing, though it is also increasing, this is good one, dominant, but this is also increasing, as a result undesirable traits, and you know these genotypes generally undesirable characters comes, that is called maybe different genetic defects sometimes will come from this genotype, because this is our recessive genes comes together, and all the recessive genotypes generally lethal or semi-lethal. Okay, so this is undesirable traits comes into increasing frequency. Another one is growth. Second point is growth rate. What will be effect on growth? It has seen that growth rate is also decreased. So in the farm animals, different growth rates are also decreased due to the inbreeding proceeds, then you will see the its growth will be less, reduced. Another one is reproductive efficiency on reproductive performance. Reproductive performance. What is this? So due to inbreeding, very important one is this, highly affects inbreeding reproductive performance or efficiency, reproductive efficiency decrease. What are the different reproductive efficiency? In case of male, there is a libido, then testicular development decrease, then number of ova cells, in case of male. In case of female, number of ovulation cells decrease, then sexual puberty delayed. So another one is embryonic death. embryonic death rate decrease. So these are the all reproductive efficiency overall in the inbred animals is very highly affected. This is the most important trait which is mostly affected by inbreeding, reproductive performance or efficiency. Other is also decreased, but most important is reproductive performance highly affected by inbreeding. Also, what about different performance traits, production traits? So, effects on vigor, vigor, okay. What is vigor? Vigor means viability. This is also viability of the animal also decrease. That means animal will be very sensitive to the environment and that is vigor will be decreased. So viability, then non-inbred, more susceptible to the stress condition. Another one is your effect on production traits. So if we say the what is the phenotypic effect of inbreeding on production traits, also it has seen that in case of animal, dairy animals, milk yield production decrease, fat yield decrease. So in case of dairy animals, dairy cattle, what we see, milk yield decrease, fat percent also sometimes decrease. For sheep, it has seen that stapple length decrease, fleece weight also decrease. So this is overall what we have seen, that phenotypic effect of inbreeding all generally reduce or decrease. So this is a ill effect, or we can call it is a inbreeding depression. Inbreeding depression, that means production of all overall performance is average or mean decrease. So this is all about your genetic effect of inbreeding and phenotypic effect of inbreeding. Okay.